It's day three of the swimming competition of the Chengdu 2021 FISU World University Games as we welcome you to the Dong'an Lake Sports Park Aquatic Center for this medal session. Plenty of action for you to enjoy, but the host nation has dominated the opening 2 days of competition, winning 5 of the 10 gold medals on offer so far. The world's very best student athletes in China for the 31st FISU World University Games. Time now for the men's 200 meter freestyle final. The first final on day three of competition. Li, Q, Navikonis, Caserta, Dahlgren, Siradsky, Chen and Jones will go in this final. Pressure on Chen, potentially, but he's risen to the occasion with personal bests in the water. Italy's Caserta. This time in the semi, saw him go out rather measured, being over a second slower than Dahlgren's time over the opening 100, but he finished so fast that he came home with a top time in the semis. Don't discount Q of Malaysia. He's second fastest in the field with a 147.81. Li, Q, Navikonis, Caserta, Dahlgren, Siradsky, Chen and Jones. The men's 200-meter freestyle final is underway. Good reaction time from Li of Korea going in lane one, but the best reaction time from the man in the favoured lane, Giovanni Caserta. It's Dahlgren, though, who comes up from the underwater in front, if only just by half a head from the Polish swimmer on his outside, Siradsky, the 21-year-old, with a 148 PB. The man going nicely in lane one is Li Yuyun, the 22-year-old, is leaving it all out there, it seems, and he touches first, just 400th of a second ahead of Dahlgren. Caserta is managing his race. He really impressed coming up to the 100 in the finish wall split. 27.13, 27.53 for Caserta coming back down the pool. Dahlgren went out 24, swam 26, and then 28-28 effectively in the semi-finals. We know he can still go faster. How does he strategize and play his tactics out for this race? It's still Li ahead of Dahlgren, and Caserta within striking distance, half a second off the pace. There's wonderful technique from these swimmers. Q of Malaysia needs to make a little bit of a move if he is to come into this race. He doesn't look like he's able to do so. He's left himself a little too much to do. Li of Korea, though, is going along nicely and leads after 100 meters. But coming up to the 150-meter mark, it is going to be Navikonis, the Lithuanian, who is in front, just ahead of Dahlgren. Caserta a little behind. That was an impressive leg by Navikonis. Has he got enough of a lead, and can he hold on in the closing 50 meters? 25 meters to go now. Navikonis is being caught by Caserta and Dahlgren. Even Siradsky is in on the mix here. Siradsky is finishing really quickly. He is pushing. Great intensity from the Polish swimmer going in lane six. Navikonis is trying to hold on. Will he do it to the wall? It is Siradsky ahead of Navikonis with Caserta of Italy out-touching Dahlgren. What a finish. Kamil Siradsky, take a bow. That was impressive. The last 50 meters was exceptional. He paced himself so well in the opening 50. Caserta misses out. 147.84 PB in the semi-finals. He can only go 148.01 to touch third in the final. But a 147.6 for Siradsky. A new personal best, and now a champion at Chengdu 2021. Adding to Poland's already impressive medal haul at Chengdu 2021. So much control it takes to reel yourself in over the opening 100 and know you've got something left in the back end. 1/13 of a second separates Siradsky from Navikonis, who just couldn't hold on. A 148.01 for Caserta. He finishes in the medals and adds to Italy's impressive medal haul. In the men's 200-meter freestyle, Giovanni Caserta is the bronze medalist. Tomas Navikonis the silver medalist. But Kamil Siradsky, who touched fourth at the halfway mark, put together a superb back end, including a lightning final 50 to snatch gold spectacularly. To the women's 100-meter breaststroke final we go. The top seven swimmers went sub-110 in the semi-finals. This could be A feisty affair in the pool. The second final on the evening program. Women's 100-meter breaststroke. Miyasaka, Cheng, Standara, Titarevkova, Corbett, Ogata, Yang and Lin. Good reaction time from Miyasaka, so too from Titarevkova and Yang, going in 4 and 7. Kayleen Corbett comes into her stroke now, and Kayleen Corbett is just behind Titarevkova, who's looking to go out really quickly. Now we know she is kind of swimmer that likes to go out really hard and then hold it in the back end. Going in three, Stundera has found her stroke, and she's swimming with some intensity here. Corbett is managing herself, but she's generally quicker over the back 50. Soto going in one is Miyasaka of Japan, but she's just outside the top three. It is Titarevkova ahead of Stundera, with Corbett within 0.6 of a second in the third. Corbett, look how she used the turn, the underwater, and look at her back 50 now. Corbett is coming to her own. Titarevkova is being caught by Corbett. Kayleen Corbett of South Africa, out of the University of Pretoria. Only one medal. It's Corbett who's fading now. It's Titarevkova who is making up ground on Stundera. Stundera, Corbett, and Titarevkova are going to be the three medalists, but in what order? At the stroke, it's going to be Titarevkova ahead of Corbett, ahead of Stundera. The South African gets the silver, but Titarevkova imperious. Wonderful swim from the Lithuanian. Out quickly and came home in a similar time to Corbett and Stundera. Corbett looking to push the pace in the closing 50, but couldn't make up the ground that she lost in the opening 50. Ogata just completely out of it in the end. Miyasaka dropping to eighth. Missing out in the medal was Ogata, and she touched fourth. But no doubt about the top three, they were well ahead. 106s for the top two, Titarevkova and Corbett. And Stundera, a medalist, and she touches third. In the women's 100-meter breaststroke, it's Titarevkova who takes gold. Corbett of South Africa takes silver and bronze to Dominika Stundera of Poland. Now for the final of the women's 100-meter freestyle. Fitkiewicz goes in four, but she's going to have a battle against Chang of China, who goes in three, and South Africa's Gallagher, who goes in five. Janitskova, Antonio, DiNocenzo are certainly still in the mix for medals, and don't discount Carnet and Kufler from out wide. There's the South African, Gallagher, who faced off with Chang in the 50 fly final. The home favourite won. They both tied with 55.06s to qualify outside of the fastest qualifier, Fitkiewicz of Poland, who goes in four. Janitskova and Antonio both touched in 25.29s. The top five swimmers separated by a quarter of a second over 100 metres. This is the final of the women's 100 free. Kuchler, Antonio, Chang, Fitkiewicz, Gallagher, Janitskova, DiNocenzo and Carnet. DiNocenzo of Italy, she went 54.33 and 54.77 in her 100-meter freestyle legs of the two relay races that she swam freestyle. A good start is going to set her up nicely for a challenge for a medal. Zhang Yufei, though, is absolutely blitzing the opening half of this course. Going from lane three, she has put down the foot on the pedal, so to speak. In lane three, she is leading by a body length as she comes now to the wall at 50 and touches in a very fast 25.20. She's ahead of Gallagher at the moment. Fitkiewicz is battling to keep up with Gallagher in five, and Zhang of China going in three, but she's still in the top three and in with a place for medals. Trying to make a ground going in lane six is Janitskova of Czechia. The 100-meter freestyle comes down to the final 25 meters, and it's Zhang Yufei going for her fourth gold medal, her second individual, and she'll claim it by a body length here ahead of Erin Gallagher of South Africa. Zhang wins ahead of Gallagher. Antonio comes back to win the first medal in the pool for Cyprus at Chengdu 2021, 54.82, but the time is 53.34. It's a FISU record for Zhang Yufei. 53 low would have been a time she was targeting, the FISU record that stood at 53.5 from Hirasumi Inia. For a good 10 years, took it out hard, touching it 25.20 at the 50. And then 53.34 coming in home in 28 seconds. Gallagher second. Fitkiewicz misses out on the podium as Antonio out touches her at the wall. Kalia Antonio of Cyprus is the bronze medalist. South Africa's Erin Gallagher gets silver, her second of these games. But Zhang Yufei gets her fourth gold medal and second individual crown in this event, the women's 100-meter freestyle. This is the final now of the men's 200-meter individual medley. Wang Huang, Glesi, Lopes, Yun, Hiroshima, Zobel, and Daigle. Daigle is a strong back and breaststroker, so his middle section should be quick. So traditionally, the 200 and 400 individual medleys went hand in hand, but no longer. 200 IM has evolved to become an all-out sprint across all four strokes. And there's the man who is favourite for gold. Portugal have already won a medal at these games through Camila Rebelo, but a chance now for gold for Gabriel Almeida Lopes. The men's 200-meter individual medley final. Huang, Glesi, Almeida, Lopes, Yun, Hiroshima, Zobel, and Daigle. Lopes looked sublime in the semi-finals, splitting 25.86 on fly, 29.68 on back. Lost his massive lead in the breaststroke, but held on in the free to clock the fastest time in the semi-finals. How will he go in this final? He looks to be just in front at the moment. Going well in lane one is Wang of Chinese Taipei. He is an excellent fly swimmer, very strong free swimmer. It's his middle section where he really needs to watch out. It is Wang who touches first ahead of Almeida Lopes of Portugal by 1/100th of a second. Yun of Korea, 0.4 off the mark at the moment as the swimmers turn into the backstroke. Lopes is still looking good. Daigle is a strong backstroke and breaststroker, so this is where he should make a push to challenge, and he's looking from lane 8 to make a bit of a push. And he's only up into about 5th position at the moment, still leading the way. Going in lane 4 is Almeida Lopes of Portugal, the Tokyo Olympian, ahead of Wang. Glesi touches 3rd quickest for Italy as he comes into his own. He's solid in the backstroke. He went 30-28 in the back leg in the semi-finals. And he's gone really quickly here as well. The breaststroke is where the race often gets decided. Daigle is strong. Hiroshima, one to watch in the breaststroke. 34.70 in the semi-finals. Look at the underwater work. Great glide, good kick as well. Such control in this race. 1:29.24 at the wall for Almeida Lopes of Portugal, who leads. He's a body length in front at the moment of Wang, nearly 2 seconds back. Hiroshima is still in the middle, so over 2 seconds down. It's going to be a chase to the wall here. He's got too much on any other competitor in the pool. It's not going to be easy to challenge for the bronze medal, though. There are 5 swimmers that are potentially in with a shout of making the podium. The man who's going to win it is from Portugal. Gabriel José Almeida Lopes is going to come to the wall. Wang of Chinese Taipei is going to touch second. But the man third is Zobel after a fantastic final 100. He comes to the wall to add to Germany's medal tally. Armbruster, a gold for Germany already at these championships, but Zobel now has some success. The great success in the pool, though, was for Almeida Lopes of Portugal. Paced himself brilliantly, again, sublime in the fly. Went out 25.34, not the quickest. Wang was quickest in the fly, but then he was the quickest in the back, quickest in the breast and free. Not the 150 and 200 meter mark as he came home comfortably ahead. Gabriel José Almeida Lopes of Portugal goes sub 2 minutes, 1:59.12 ahead of Wang, with Marius Zobel of Germany out touching Huang of China. In the men's 200 meter individual medley, Marius Zobel with bronze, silver to Wang Xinghua Hao of Chinese Taipei, but the gold brilliantly done from Gabriel Almeida Lopes to win from Wang the gold. Now to the final of the men's 1500 meters, 1500 meter freestyle final. Maturano Ruffini, Marcello, Nagi, Imoto, Giovannoni, Tabucci, Hoagland, and Zhang. 2 swimmers from Japan, 2 swimmers from USA, 2 Italian swimmers with a Brazilian and a Korean. Zhang going in lane 8 for Republic of Korea. Japan has 2 medal hopefuls. Hoagland, a personal best in the preliminaries. Nagy, out of University of Minnesota, studying computer engineering. He goes in lane 3, and capable of medaling undoubtedly. Maturano Ruffini, Marcello, Nagy, Imoto, Giovannoni, Tabucci, Hoagland and Zhang. This is the final of the men's 1,500 metre freestyle, the longest event in the pool, 30 lengths in what is genuinely a grueling event. It takes years to master and much comes down to pacing. Times are really important, but they are secondary at these major events. The best swimmers want the medals and it's about finishing ahead of others. It looks like the man in front, Tabucci of Japan, is going out really quickly. His compatriot Imoto had a really good reaction time, which is important, so too are the turns. Hoagland is second at the moment, Tabucci and Imoto both inside the top three, but nobody really breaking up the field as yet, although it looks like there might have been a bit of a threat from Tabucci to go out and do so, but he's not exactly extending his advantage here, and Hoagland alongside him is sort of holding on. Giovannoni, though, looks to be swimming his own race. He's not in the top three for the time being. Might just come up fourth to the wall at the 100-meter mark. And it's still 1,400 meters to go in this final. Giovannoni, Hoagland and Nagy have the fast closing laps, so if they're within striking distance of any other swimmer, we're certainly in for a treat. Not quite a four-swimmer breakaway at the moment, but Imoto, Giovannoni, Tabucci, and the American going in lane seven, Hoagland, is trying to keep pace. Nagy as well has moved up a little, 3:31.78. He touched just outside the top three, but that's a good swim from the two Japanese swimmers, Imoto and Tabucci and Giovannoni. Technique is critical in this race. Watch the high elbow, low breath. It's a mantra of the coaches, high elbow, low breath, controlled head movement. What that does is it limits the body movement that would slow a swimmer down, limits the resistance in the pool. Just over half a second now, Giovannoni is leading from Tabucci with Imoto third. Her technique is genuinely critical in this race. So reducing the drag, reducing the resistance so that you expend as little energy as possible over the grueling distance in the pool is key. It's almost allowing the legs just to float in the water is Giovannoni. He's not really expending much energy with the legs. You'll see that tempo upped in the closing stages. He touches at the wall now through the 450 mark, 4:31.81, nearly a second over Tabucci. Imoto now a second and a half back. Now we've just gone through the halfway mark of the race, 7:34.28 for Giovannoni at the wall at 7:50. Reaching the 8-minute mark, now we go, coming up to the 800-meter mark. Giovannoni leads by nearly 2 seconds from Tabucci. Nagy maintains that third position ahead of Imoto of Japan. There's so many other aspects in this race to be cognizant of. Training has evolved. Nutrition has evolved. Nutrition during training is absolutely vital. Just look at how little his legs are moving. You can see from this glorious underwater shot. Had a great turn as well. Doesn't use much of the underwater, but a very streamlined movement from Giovannoni. So minimizing drag in the pool. He's got his lead up now to over 2 seconds over Tabucci. Nagy's nearly 5 seconds off the pace at the moment. 8:35.10 at the 850 mark for Giovannoni of Italy. And we know he's quick to close. He is going to be difficult to catch. Look at his turn as well. Turns might not be considered overly important in distance events, but they have to be because of the sheer number of turns. If you look at the 1,500 meter event, there are 29 turns, for example. So when you consider that some swimmers have been calculated to lose 0.5 of a second per turn, that's 14 and a half seconds added to your potential time over 1,500 meters. Giovannoni is executing his turns brilliantly, and he is just edging further and further in front of Tabucci. Nagy is falling off the pace of Tabucci and Giovannoni, but he's still in medal position at the moment. You'll see swimmers sometimes try in little bursts to up their tempo, and that's what Tabucci seems to have tried to do. Nagy, still currently in third, is coming to the wall now, but Giovannoni is ahead of Tabucci, but that gap is closing. I don't know if Tabucci has enough left in the pool, enough room left in the pool to try to make up ground on Giovannoni. and genuinely challenge him for the gold medal here. A little more of a leg kick every so often now from Giovannone, but still minimal use of legs. Great turn in the pool. 150 meters to go. Tabucci is second. Nagy is 8.5 seconds behind now, but importantly, he is ahead of Imoto of Japan. These swimmers well and truly out in front. The Italian who leads from the Japanese swimmer. They go in lanes 5 and 6. He takes the bell now. It's 100 meters to go in the longest event in the pool. 30 lengths in this pool. Nearly done. Giovannone and Tabucci representing their universities with pride. They're both 21 years old. Nagy of USA currently in third. Looks like he's got the bronze medal wrapped up, but gold almost certainly now going to Giovannone of Italy. He turns with 50 meters to go, 14:41.94. He leads by under 3 seconds. But that is a comfortable lead for Ivan Giovannone of Italy. Tabuchi Kaito of Japan is closing the gap. It's been a stellar effort, but the strategy and tactic of the Italian has been absolutely superb. Working on his mental strength, working on his physical strength, he's going to claim the title here and add to the Italian gold medal tally. Giovannone is the champion of the 1,500 meters ahead of Tabucci of Japan, while Nagy of USA comes home in third as he claims a bronze medal, the man from San Diego. Touching fourth, coming home just outside the medals. Here's the champion, Giovannone. Controlled this race from start to finish, did Giovannone. Preparation and opportunity led the swimmers to this point. And he did not let up in the pool. Excellent technique. Swam his race. Hit the front through the opening 200 meters, Giovannone. And then would not be caught. 15:11.81, good enough to win gold. Tabucci second, 15:14.60. Nagy of USA touches ahead of Marcello of Italy. The final medals in the pool on day three of the swimming competition go to Chris Nagy of USA, who takes bronze, Japan's Tabucci Kaito, who secures silver, and Italy's Ivan Giovannone, who claimed an outstanding gold.